Right. I'm delighted to hear that Kerala is being so proactive. This is a big challenge, and what Kerala thinks today, hopefully India will think tomorrow. Clearly, you are taking no chances, and that's why you've decided to take this major step. I appreciate your joining us, Dr. Exactly. Kettle, and telling us why Kerala has taken this big step to control coronavirus.
As COVID-19 fear grips in Kerala, the state health department and various other departments are working in tandem in full throttle to ensure and to contain the spread of this lethal disease. We are right now in the State Disaster Emergency Response Room, or the control room as it's called, which is now used as a facility to track, analyze and monitor the patients, their movements and also the contacts. So I will quickly call your attention to this big screen over here. There are actually four big screens which are set up here, which is actually coordinated and controlled by the team of experts which are sitting there. So to give you an overview, this is actually one of the screens, one of the maps which is being put in place. As you can see here, this is actually a geographical location of Pathanamthitta, where we can see multiple pinpoints over here. So right now this pinpoint is near the Chengannur area, and all these pinpoints or the anchor drops where we can say actually mentions, or this actually notes that there is a person who is under high risk or lower risk. So if we click in one of these particular anchor points, it will give us this data. That is the number. The first thing that you see, the number is actually the number or the time at which this was actually recorded. So this is actually the 45th record which has come. The location is Punalur, and the total number of cases are actually 8, I believe. And then we have the primary cases, which is 5, the secondary is 0, and there are actually high-risk cases, which are actually 6, I believe. And there are a total of 15 cases in this location. Like this, there are many other locations which are pinpointed in the map based on the contact tracing. So during this corona COVID-19 surveillance, there is a lot of confusion and questions about what happens during this surveillance and how is this contact tracing being done. So this is exactly what goes behind the contact tracing, because I just want you to look at these maps once again, because this is how they have managed to pinpoint these people specifically from each and every area. And right now I will just seek the help of one of the senior analysts over here, the hazard analyst, Mr. Rono Matthew. He has been coordinating the activities over here. So why don't you just walk us through these maps? Initially we will start from this map and then we will progress to other varieties as well.
Yeah. This map actually gives us location-wise data of the contacts of cases. Cases are those who have the disease. Contacts are those who have been in contact with the cases. So we can actually point on a particular point and we can get the details of the particular contact over there. So pinpointing on a particular point data. These are all point. This is what we call point data.
All these are places where there are
places and all points where there are contacts. So these are specific geographic locations with latitude and longitude. So we can click on this and find out the coordinates, geo-coordinates, latitude and longitude of the particular area. And the details of contacts. So not cases, but these are contacts. Cases are those with the disease.
Can you just walk us through the data over here with the location and the coordinates?
Yes. So we are actually segregating these contacts based on whether the contact is primary contact or whether they are secondary contact. So primary contacts are those which have direct contact with the cases. Secondary contacts are those which do not have direct contact with the cases. High risk contacts are those which are having higher risk of developing the disease, and low risk contacts are those which are having relatively lower risk of developing the disease. So all these details we are including here. Here you can see X and Y, geo coordinates. These are the geographical location specificals of this particular area.
Sir, can we just go to these maps? Why are there different colors on these maps?
These are not different colors. These are lighter and darker colors over here. Light one is for the low risk contacts, and the darker color is for the high risk contacts. So actually you can see medium risk also, but we are actually considering high risk and low risk as two particular classifications.
So as per going per this particular map, the high risk location is somewhere around here. Is this the area close to Rani?
Yeah, this is the area close to Rani. You can see over here, you can see high risk contacts over here, and surrounding the particular area, you can see low risk contacts, which like low risk is represented by lighter shade, high risk is represented by darker shade.
Orange area is actually a, what do you call, medium risk?
Yeah, medium risk, actually based on classification we have high risk and low risk. Medium risk you can identify just because it is having a, you know, there are more number of low risk cases over there, like, so it's actually high risk and low risk, not medium risk. This is high risk and this is low risk.
So what are the other mapping types that you have created over here? The heat wave thing.
We have created a heat map over here. Heat map, please. Yeah, this we call as a heat map. So this also shows what kind of risk the particular contact is having of developing the disease. So this is high risk area. So these particular areas are having high risk contacts. So you can see this in red. So these are the high risk areas. And these areas with blue shade are the low risk areas which have lower risk of developing the disease. That is how this is actually classified.
And so, yeah, we have
this map also is similar with high risk contacts mapped in red and low risk contacts mapped in blue.
So is this kind of a different version of what we see over here without the heat or without the risk density mentioned?
Yeah, these are actually two different types of maps but representing the same idea. This is based on the particular point with your coordinates. And this actually gives us a rough distribution of where the contacts are.
Okay.
So geographical distribution.
And sir, how is this actually used to analyze? You know, where are we getting this data from? How is this being analyzed?
This data is obtained from Department of Health and Family Welfare. So we are getting the data every day on a daily basis from the Department of Health. Regarding the cases, we are getting data on a real-time basis. And regarding the contacts, we are getting data on a daily basis. So this is daily data that we get from the Department of Health and Family Welfare, and this is mapped on a daily basis. So this map will be actually updated on a daily basis as we get more data from the Department of Health and Family Welfare, and this will help us in tracing those contacts. So you can see in which area the contacts are more, and we have contact details of each and every contact, so we have opportunity to contact them and ask them to be either in isolation or to be cautious.
So now over the last 2 days we have having reports that some of the high risk contacts have tested negative. Yeah. So in those cases, will these high risk points like the red, will it change to blue? Will you just degrade that level of caution?
No. Once the contact is high risk contact, it will remain a high risk contact. So we are not actually degrading it. There is no purpose in degrading it because the risk still persists and the high risk contact will remain high risk contact. And after testing negative also, we won't degrade the risk of that particular contact.
So tell us more about your team. How many of you are actually working? You know, how is the total working happening over here?
This is a multidisciplinary team. We have a multidisciplinary team working over here. We have experts from different specialties working over here on a daily basis. So we can see different kinds of maps over there. This is another map which was created for monitoring corona COVID-19. See another map over there. So we have a multidisciplinary team working over here. So
and is this team working round the clock in shift, or are you working only around like office?
No, this office works round the clock. We are working 24/7. We will have staff working 24/7 over here, whether it is emergency time or not. So that is how we work over here.
And is the health department in direct touch with you? How are they providing the data? Is there any particular time in the day when you will get the data, or is it just getting as and when it's reserved?
We are getting the data every day at 3 p.m. in the afternoon. So after getting the data, we'll be sorting the data according to our requirement. And then we'll be making maps out of those data and we'll be providing them the maps. That's how we're doing it every day. So every day at sharp 3 p.m., we're getting the data from Department of Health and Family Welfare. We're giving them the maps.
Are you planning to make this data available for the general public without revealing the data or the information of these patients or the high-risk contacts?
Currently, the data is being used for official purpose. So we'll be taking a call based on expert opinion and based on decision of the authorities. We'll be taking a call in making the data available to the public. But as of now, this is for official purpose.
All right, sir. Thank you so much for speaking to us. So that was Mr. Rono Matthew, one of the chief coordinators of this whole activity or this war room, as we can say. You can see the people, their energy, they are working in tandem. They are constantly monitoring the situation. And as you see behind me, these are actually large screen set up to monitor people. So this is how the state administration is trying to synchronize IT information technology along with the infos gathered from the people and from the local level. And this is how they are actually trying to create a state level monitoring facility for these people who have contracted virus and who are under potential threat of getting infected. With camera person Tingu Rajshekaran, Gopi Krishnan in Thiruvananthapuram for India Today.